Yeah, good morning students, welcome back to our channel. Yes, yesterday we were having a discussion on future continuous tense. Yes, today we are having a discussion on future perfect tense, right? I hope you are clear with present perfect tense and simple past tense and past perfect tense, right? All these three are deals with completed actions in the past, not now, in the past. So future perfect tense, what does it do is it shows an action which is going to be completed by in the future time. You see, you can say I will have completed reading this book by this time, right? I will have walked away by tomorrow this time, right? So this tense expresses the actions which would complete in the future. See, please understand, we use future perfect tense to show an action which is going to complete in the future. Yes, which is going to be completed in the future. We are assuming, it's not certain, it's not particular, it's not clear whether the action is going to be completed or not, but we are saying that action will be completed by tomorrow. Yes, I will have walked up to 10 kilometers by tomorrow. Yes, like that. I hope you are clear with the examples. Let's learn how we can frame the different kinds of sentences using future perfect tense. First one, as we all know, first one is affirmative sentence or positive sentence. How can we make? Here subject will is helping verb. Yes, shall also used for some I, first person and second person, but that's outdated. Now nobody is using shall. Yes, subject plus will, then have, then past participle. Past participle means what? Verb form 3, right? For example, he will have done it by this evening, right? By this evening. Then how can you make negative sentence? Very easy. Subject should be there, then will, then not, then have, then past participle. I will not have done it by this evening. Then will, how can you make negative one? Negative one is completed. Then interrogative one, questioning one, will, then subject, then have, then past participle. Very easy one. Will he have done it by this evening? Right? Easy one. So some examples I have taken. First one is, I will have been here for 6 months on June 23rd. Yes? It's saying I will have been here for 6 months on 23rd. Yes, by the time you read, I will have left. You will have finished your report by this time next week. Won't they have arrived by 5? Will you have eaten when I pick you up? Right, these are some examples. Just I want you to frame some more examples using the structure I have given you, right? So if you have any queries, please write in the comment section. While writing in the comment section, please be specific what you didn't understand, right? Thank you for watching this video.